I like my food local. You know where my cows have been.
Hi, my name is Hans Peter Meyer, and today I'm talking to Barbara Odegaard of Ironwood Farm in the Comox Valley. We're here in the Native Sons Hall downtown Courtney, which is the winter home for the Comox Valley Farmers Market. But we're talking about Ironwood Farm. Barbara, how did you get to Ironwood Farm?
Brian and I came to Ironwood Farm in 1996. It was an opportunity that happened very quickly. We were living in Parksville for many years, and Brian was a commercial fisherman for many years, and we wanted to transition out of that, and had a love of growing food for a long, long time, and decided it was now or never. We needed to find a bigger piece of property because we wanted to be certified organic and offer a local community great natural local produce.
So, like, what's the process around getting certified, and why did you choose that?
Well, almost 20 years ago, it was a fairly new process, and we wanted to distinguish ourselves and grow food in the most natural, organic way. There was a lot of misinformation, and we found that going the certified organic route was going to connect us with those channels that gave us that information and guided us through what we needed to know at the time.
You're one of the few farmers at the market here who, that you and Brian are making a full-time living off the farm. Does being organic have something to do with that, or how do you do that?
I don't know if being certified organic has anything to do with that. I think it has more to do with realizing what your limitations are, living within your limitations, and realizing that this is really where you want to be, and you're going to dig your heels in and be tenacious and make it work.
I guess what I'm looking at is being organic, is there a significant market for that now? Is that part of the reason why you're able to live off the farm?
I think so. Being certified organic, I actually do reviews for the province for the association we're involved with, and I'm always astounded at what I'm learning. There's so many products coming on the market and going off the market, and I would find it very, very difficult not being part of an organic association to actually keep up with distinguishing what products are actually organic and which aren't, because there's a lot of fillers and agents and things that a lot of people think are organic and safe but actually aren't. And through the association, we get fed that information. It's constantly changing, and trying to keep up with it just as an individual layperson, I don't know how I do that or where I'd find the time to do that.
One of the things you've talked about in terms of the changes you've seen around the market is the number of young people who are, you know, coming here, bringing their young families here, and their interest in the kind of flavor and the kind of integrity that you're talking about. And you also described that about the people who've come to work at your farm. Can you talk a bit about how, you know, what they think about those things?
Well, I think it's fantastic. We've definitely noticed that there are more and more young people moving into the valley and with their young children. And I think we're sort of seeing the first generation where there's sort of been a gap between the connection of their ancestors, grandparents, parents who have actually grown up on farms. So there's been this a missing link. There's a connection, but something's missing. And we've hosted young people, up to 1,000 of them, from all over the world, and we're always so amazed at the transformation that takes place when they spend time on the farm. Most of them have never ever had their hands in the dirt or grown anything, and it's just marvelous seeing them be part of that process and how it's been mind-boggling how it's transformed some of them. Many of them have had epiphanies doing this kind of work and have gone home and have a much greater appreciation for the food that's on their table. Mm-hmm. They now understand why their grandparents or their parents like to grow things and have gone home and are now helping them. We get pictures sent to us, Barbara, Brian, look at, I've got my own garden going. And it humbles us to think that this little farm in Fannie Bay is inspiring young people all over the world to make this connection again and linking themselves to good food and getting their hands in the dirt. It's great.
How big is your farm?
We have 11 and a half acres, but we farm probably about 4.
Wow, so you're making a living off of 4 acres. Tell me about how important the farmers market has been in what you do.
One of the reasons we did come here is we found a great piece of property, of course, but we did do some research and found out there was a farmers market here. It was probably a couple of years old by the time we landed here, and I can look back at the old pictures. It was still very small and just in its infancy, and it's been so great, such a pleasure to watch this market grow and engage more and more farmers, more and more vendors, and of course more and more customers. And it's been such a pleasure to watch people's children grow up and those children having children and still coming and participating in the market.
Okay. What kind of stuff are you growing at your farm?
Well, we grow just about anything you can think of. One of the luxuries of about being a market garden, you can grow and experiment and play around with what you want. But predominantly you're doing the leeks and onions and squash and potatoes and greens, all kinds of greens, hundreds of kinds of greens. We have some fruit trees and we do strawberries, we do herbs, and we do lots of flowers too.
Oh yeah? Mm-hmm. So you've got a small farm stand at your farm, is that right?
We do. We do, and we also raise chickens, uh-huh. Organic chicken for sale, and we have a stand at our farm in Fannie Bay.
Right, but most of the time, most of your business is done here through the market.
Yeah, most of our business has been through the farmers market. Yeah.
And are you here 12 months of the year?
We are here 12 months of the year, and that was a work in progress. When we first started, it was very much a seasonal market. And as farmers on the board and that, you know, we worked hard to push it into a winter market, and from there it progressed into what is now a full-time year-round market. But it's part of what's enabled us to make a full-time living at it.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for taking the time here, Barbara.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure. Thanks, Hans Peter Munger. Your whole name.
And thank you for watching, and I hope you come down and visit the market this winter in the Native Sons Hall. There's always a bit of a festive atmosphere here, and it does feel really good to be here.
I like my food local. Wanna know my fish swam up a stream. I like my food local.